What keeps you going? What are your constants? These two questions are important when we talk about what sustains a person. INFJ types go through a lot of things, and so it goes without saying that they need something that would keep them sane and also keep them going. I'm going to show you the 10 things that sustain the INFJ. Number 10, their independence. Most INFJ types, if not all of them, are self-reliant. Depending on other people is rarely their first choice because they tend to dislike inconveniencing others. As long as they can, INFJ types would take a burden or any load of work by themselves. This picture of independence is something that somehow fuels their urge to continue living and do better day by day. Besides, there's nothing that feels better than being able to do things and making things possible by your own hands. And the INFJ really enjoys this one. Inconveniencing others is something the INFJ dreads to do. They just don't like to be the cause of someone else's inconvenience. That's why they would rather do things on their own, and they enjoy it anyway. Number 9. Their ideals. Apart from their independence, INFJ types sometimes hold on to their own visions and ideas to keep them going. When people fail them and situations don't go their way, INFJ types are left with their own selves and minds to cling on to and to keep them sane. Sometimes the reality that at the end of the day, you only have yourself rings true for the INFJ. There are times when other people just find it too hard to relate to them, and so they have to rely on their own selves to cheer themselves up to keep going. There are some things that are really just non-negotiable for an INFJ, and no one can break that. They can be pretty tough on their ideals. Their friends could either just respect it or one couldn't bear it. The INFJ would also just respect that but probably would say goodbye to that friend too. What are your ideals? Number 8. Their empathy. Though quite independent, most INFJ types recognize the importance of having people around. Although they're introverts, they acknowledge the fact that no man is an island and that they will not be able to do things on their own forever. There may be times when empathy plays a vital role in sustaining them somewhat on a daily basis, even when they don't really take notice. INFJ types aren't only self-reliant, they're reliable in a general sense. They have a desire to be trusted and to help others out. The sense of being needed is sometimes something that can motivate them in many ways. So yes, there's a possibility that when they're having a bad day, they'll do some random act of kindness with their own empathy in play to brighten their day. Number 7. Their alone time. Of course, one can't forget this when introversion is a huge part of one's personality. INFJ's alone time is precious, so much so that they would almost trade anything for it. Forget about joining the lunch out with friends or colleagues. INFJ types may make up an excuse to go home or go somewhere else where they can be by themselves once again. Not even their closest friend or lover can sometimes convince them to give up their time alone to spend some time together. INFJ types can sacrifice other aspects of their lives just to keep their own time, as this is vital in sustaining them. For an INFJ, this is their time to recharge, to self-reflect, or even just a time of quiet. In a world full of people and full of noise, the INFJ could be drained and just feel empty. This is why the INFJ is willing to trade anything for this, because their quiet time allows them to be themselves once again. Number 6. A quiet place. Now, not only is time vital, but having their own space as well is important for an INFJ. Having their own space to unwind and sort out their thoughts is one of the things that sustain the INFJ. This works well with having their time alone. Though INFJ types may find some mastery in finding peace despite a chaotic or distracting environment, it still isn't the same as really being in a quiet place where there are lesser or no people around and with no one or not much to distract the INFJ. This doesn't necessarily mean they're meditating or they're self-reflecting, but this is the time the INFJ gives to themselves to be able to get away from the noisy, cruel, and uncertain reality. This is where they enjoy their mind palaces and being on their own while doing their own thing, their safe space. How do you picture your own safe space? Number 5. Their loved ones. INFJ types, or should I say, everyone, need some constants in their ever-changing mood and life in general. Given that they can be quite challenging to be with and tough to understand, INFJ types need some people or maybe even just one person with them who would continue to support them unwaveringly. INFJ types also experience some moments where they can no longer handle things and they need someone who would either help them out or would just listen to their thoughts and struggles. These people can give the right amount of push and sustaining power when they need it. When times get tough and some things get out of hand, the INFJ, just like everyone else, turns to their loved ones for strength, hope, and support. Although they're pretty independent themselves, they're still only humans, and we all need a little kindness and some sprinkle of love from the people we value most too. Number 4. Beauty. A little inspiration can go a long way, and even INFJ types aren't immune to beautiful sceneries, and yes, even people as well. Something beautiful is hard to miss, and INFJ types will have a hard time missing it too, as they're one of the personality types who have an eye for it, and also appreciates beauty as well. It kind of inspires them and awakens that poetic soul inside of them. Sometimes, after a hard day or a struggle, seeing beautiful scenery can lighten their burden and even inspire them to strive harder. Nature is probably an INFJ's best friend in doubt. They like to go back or go to a place that would remind them how beautiful the world still is, despite its despites. Nature becomes their safe zone and their comfort place. Number 3. Their accuracy in things. Does being right or accurate sustain a person? Yes, it does, in various ways. Being on the wrong side often can be disheartening for people, and for the INFJ types, it could spiral into something much more destructive to their mental health. In another note, INFJ types do have a knack in being accurate, especially that they're equipped with their empathy and intuition. They like to do things in the most political and socially accepted way. Number 2. Their perspective. People say it really depends on the person how he or she sees a certain situation. INFJ types may not be the cheeriest of the MBTI bunch, but they do think, analyze, and counterbalance a lot. And when life throws them tough situations and they're forced to face reality with all they have, there's only one thing that INFJ types first turn to: their mind. They go through their thoughts and engage with some self-talk before doing anything. Number 1. Their unwavering belief in things. We're back to talking about the INFJ mind. Well, nothing too surprising there, as INFJ types are avid thinkers. They're also known to stick with their own thoughts and stand by their beliefs. This ability of theirs to stand by what they believe in is also something that could propel them forward and allow them to cope through various trials that they may face. And so, even when the odds are against them, and even when people around them question the INFJ, this stubborn belief of theirs sometimes becomes their own lifeline when the going gets super tough. And those are some 10 things that help sustain the INFJ. There are more of these things that could aid this personality to face their everyday challenges and keep on with both the mundane and special happenings in their lives. Well, the listed things may not solely apply to INFJ types as well. Can you relate? What more can you add to this list? Let us know in the comments section below. Do you have topics in mind? We will be glad to make them for you. Don't forget to like, share this content with your friends and family, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching!